everybody, like when Han and Chewie made their appearance, you know, their first introduction appearance in the movie, there were cheers and claps and stuff. And then when the Millennium Falcon, you know, made its first appearance on screen, oh, you know, everybody was happy about that and stuff. And then we see Princess Leia for the first time. We see Carrie Fisher.
Nobody made a sound.
No reaction. But then, immediately after, C-3PO, there's this little thing, and everybody's like, ah, yay! And I was just like, this oh, man, incredible. Carrie Fisher got zero fucking reaction.
Have you guys ever seen CHAW on the internet by any chance?
Seen what?
That sounds like an STD.
It does.
Like he's got the CHAW.
He's got the CHAW. But it happens on the show. Oh, apparently we need to back the fuck up. We're forgetting stuff.
What are we doing?
We forgot things.
Shit. Oh yeah, we gotta protect.
We're failing wars right now.
Yeah, we gotta protect motherfuckers while they bring this shit up. But anywho, CHAW is a video on the internet, and it's like. God, I can't remember the name of the channel. It's like Happy Hugs or Magic Hugs or something like that. They do a ton of like, you know, comedy skits, sketches or whatever on YouTube and everything.
Okay.
On the YouTube. Yeah,
the
I'm
YouTube.
An 80-year-old person now. So,
welcome
anyway,
to the YouTube.
Pokemans.
Welcome to the internet. I'll be your guide. But anyway, they do this fucking video where it's him and he's like, he's got this big ass like cowboy hat on. He has a stupid mustache. It's fucking great.
Are we done?
But he's like,
no, we're waiting
nah,
for the
we're just
up.
Still waiting
God
for them to
damn
dick around over here and pull it up because they're apparently the slowest people of all time.
Hurry up with the war.
But yeah, so with the war, we have to move.
Are you for the war?
Yeah, he actually at one point he says he's like, it's like a fucking wings marathon on USA. It's fucking terrifying. It's so funny to me that you brought that up.
Oh,
I like, yes.
Love wings. That's like one of my guilty pleasures for some
as it
reason.
Should be.
As you said, from, keep that guilty.
From my fucking childhood. Like, I don't know, it just makes me happy.
See, I feel that way about Becker, and I know a lot of people hate
Dude,
Becker
rules! I fucking love Ted Danson.
I feel like that's the first thing you guys have ever agreed on.
I think it is, actually.
Yeah. Oh my god, that's weird.
Ted's been hurting you up till now.
The fucking blind guy from Becker is awesome.
Yes, yes he is.
The fucking,
oh, shit.
And the oily weasel snake guy.
Dear
even
god.
Though you fucking hate him at the same time, you just want to know. Like,
oh my god!
Yeah, they came flying down right at me. What the fuck? But they didn't know I had a shield on.
They didn't know
pussies.
I had fucking repellent. Anyway, I've actually been to Nantucket Island, so maybe that has something to do with it, too.
Okay, alright.
I sure as hell haven't.
It's really fucking cool. It's a tiny little place with, like, tons of history. It's cool.
So like my penis.
Yes.
Yeah.
Tons of history.
Ted's got the CHAW.
All dark. Just the dark
Ted's,
ages.
Ted was the originator of the CHAW.
Patience
His dick
zero.
Invented it.
You were the template from which all CHAW was brought.
So have you guys seen that Comic-Con Ninja Turtles short from Jonah Vasquez?
No.
Oh
what?
My god, it's funny as fuck.
Oh.
God damn it.
It just makes
Vasquez?
Me wish there was a TMNT show from him.
Yeah.
Because
no
the
shit.
Humor works so great with the Turtles.
That sounds awesome.
It does sound awesome.
I want that bad.
Everything that's happening with the Turtles right now is
sucks.
Kind of shit. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a real
I
bummer.
I tried so hard to get into the animated show on Nickelodeon.
Yeah.
But it's impossible for me.
There were times I was like, ooh. You
yeah.
know? Like,
yeah,
every once in a while
too.
I'd be like, okay. But then it just fucking get down the toilet again immediately.
Yeah.
Oh. So a thing that is good, IDW... Since 2011, they've been doing a comic book, like
it's
a
good.
Reboot.
Holy
that's fucking
fuck
good.
It's good.
It's
oh my
so good.
God.
Like it
that's...
gets really fucking heavy.
Yeah, it's fucking awesome.
And but it's like a really good balance of like fucking.
They're still like their comedy and like
yeah,
they're like
they still like
cowabunga,
I love pizza dudes
oh, yeah,
kind of shit.
Oh my god.
But at the
so
same
good.
Time, it like talks about fucking reincarnation
mm-hmm.
and.
Yeah.
All these other, like,
dude,
heavy elements.
Dude, it goes into a ton of stuff.
Oh,
how far
shit.
Are you into it? Do you know it all?
Sins of Our Fathers Part 2.
Ooh!
Is the one I just finished
Dude,
up.
You're about to get crazy!
I know,
holy
I'm so
fuck.
Excited. I'm so excited.
Oh, man, I won't go into anything because it's so exciting, but, I just beat off to comic books, and that's my second favorite series.
It's so good.
What's your first favorite?
Holy fuck. Have you guys heard of Saga?
Saga! I knew you were going to say Saga!
God. Holy shit.
Saga is awesome.
Fucking Star Wars meets Romeo and Juliet meets everything cool about fucking everything ever.
Yep.
Oh my god. If you haven't read it, go get it now. We will stop now. Holy fuck. Like, seriously?
Port to book comic store.
So, I did this little thing. I went into Limited Edition, which is a comic book store, obviously, in Cedar Falls, in our
Shout
area.
Out.
And, he's my boy, Rob.
Rob's the man.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, he's always recommended way good stuff. And there's another guy in there, Tommy, who always recommends me really good stuff.
Yeah.
And so, he recommended me something called Sweet Tooth, which is fucking fantastic. So I went and I read.
Not based off of
book.
The clown from Twisted Metal.
Yeah, way cooler. But anyway, he like recommended me that, and I came back and I was like, "Yo, dude, you got any more recommendations?" And Saga had just come out with book 3, and he was like, "Read this now." He's like, "We got book 1 in today." He's like, "You won't find that for like another few months." He's like, "Buy it now, and like if you love it, then come back." So I went home. I started reading it. I went back to the comic book store the same fucking day within a 2-hour block and bought books 2 and 3 right then and there.
Hell yeah.
It's so fucking good.
So give us a brief synopsis of what it's about.
Okay, so
without
essentially,
spoiling it.
Yeah,
kind of already
yeah.
did.
Yeah. Oh yeah, Star Wars.
Star Wars.
That's not
yeah.
a synopsis.
Awesome.
That's just buzzwords.
Yeah, exactly.
It's
yeah.
one of those things though.
Oh,
like
man.
the less you know about it,
yeah,
going
it
in,
makes it super cool.
Yeah, because there's a lot of mystery, kind of majestic.
Yeah,
like
yeah,
it's the Dark Souls of comics.
Dude, yeah, they seriously like. Oh my god,
I'm just gonna keep using
yeah,
that.
The Dark Souls of everything.
It's the sci-fi Dark Souls of comics.
Yeah,
Dark
dude,
Souls
just...
is super divisive though. That doesn't bode well.
I don't know what that means.
Like, not everyone loves Dark Souls.
It's true.
If you don't like
everyone
Dark Souls,
should
you don't deserve to live. So.
Oh my god.
I don't love Dark Souls.
Bye.
Dude.
Let me
get Then we're done. Alright.
Yeah, then you should know I can't be killed by now.
Conventional weapons can't kill
Dude,
me.
Dude, I'm reading the Book of Cain right now and it's
oh,
fucking dope.
Shit.
Look at that. Reading the shit out of it!
So hard, but
so
it's
so fast! Oh, and it's done.
It's like the fucking
It was alright. It was pretty good.
Fucking Necronomicon. It's the Ex Mortis.
It was a wonderful read.
Seriously, though, snap me.
Yeah, okay. So, snap me hard, if you would. So anyway, basically what it is that there are two kind of like, it's like a civil war essentially between, not, I shouldn't say civil war, it's just a war, I'm an idiot. So it's kind of like a war between people who are from the moon and people who are from Earth basically. So there's like Moonies is what they call them, and then the Earth people. They've been at war for a really, really long time. And so what happens is like in this actual comic book, is that one Moonie who has been like basically arrested, and this all happens in like part of the first book, so it happens really fast. One Moonie who's been arrested meets an Earthling that he really likes. They have a common interest in the books that they read, so they end up falling in love, and they have a baby. And that's basically exactly, yeah. So like the Romeo and Juliet aspects, but then it's all like in space, and they travel in different planets. The characters are all fucking incredible.
The
Some
art
the best,
is dope
yeah.
as fuck,
the
too.
The art, too. Oh, my God. It looks beautiful. It's such a cool book.
Even if it's
general.
Like, oh, look at this giant space monster and his
yeah.
balls.
Yeah, you look at dicks like a ton of them, apparently. Like, it's weird. But it's still, like, it's so good, man.
It's very phallic.
Yeah, yeah, tons of dicks. That's why I like it so much. But anywho.
If there's any prospect of coming
soon,
yeah.
out. Oh, no! All right. Holy shit, there's so much going on. Okay, but yeah, they have this baby, and then it's basically, like, their fight to kind of, like, have a good life with their child, essentially.
Cool.
And still be able to, like, run from, like, the militaries that they basically were both
Fuck
from
this
the militaries from their worlds, so they have, like, a ton of other aspects going on. But then it builds so much from there into these incredible storylines for every single character that the series offers. And like, oh, dude, just go read it, honestly.
I will.
Like,
just fucking
that
do
sounds
it.
Cool.
It's the best comic book series I've read ever, honestly. And that's I know that's like a really bold thing to say, but
it's just really
it's,
epic,
yeah.
though.
It's
so
seriously
epic
is.
In scope.
Yeah, it's like
I don't know. Epic gets like overused now.
It's so grandiose. Like it's just insane.
I think Epic died off for a long time And that's the first time I've heard somebody say it in a really long time.
Really?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
So, comic books. Mm-hmm. This is comic related.
Yeah.
I saw Batman versus Superman.
Uh huh.
Not good. Not, that, not a good movie.
Not my favorite.
No.
Thing. I noticed for me, like, okay, so I went to the theater. I saw it. I'm a huge Superman hater.
Yeah.
I think he is the most broken-ass superhero, and I don't think he's interesting at all.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
So I don't like him.
Yes.
Like, but I enjoy Man of Steel a certain amount, actually. Like, I thought that was, as far as Superman movies go...
Here's the thing about Superman. Like, as OP as he is and stupid, it's cool seeing him do stuff.
Yeah, exactly. And I think that's why people fall in love with him, is because he's so overpowered and so, like, crazy badass in every way, shape, and form. But, and I'm also, God, I share an unpopular opinion here. I fucking hate Batman, too.
You hate Batman?
Yeah, that's right. Unpopular opinion. So, I'm just, I don't know. I prefer, as far as, like, superheroes
go. I prefer Aquaman.
Yeah, I'm a real big, fish fucker type of guy, so that's, I'm into that. But I don't know, like, I just, like, superheroes, Batman has dope villains. But he's not a cool superhero to me. And maybe that's just because it's like he's a rich guy and that's about like all he has. Like, I get he has like a cool background story and everything, but he's just not my cup of tea. I completely understand why everybody likes him. Nothing wrong with him. I just don't like him as much.
I have a confession to make. I only like Batman for the villains.
Yeah, exactly. Batman villains are fucking dope.
That's true.
So yeah. So I mean, like, I'm at odds with both of the heroes in this movie, or I guess like both of the main characters.
So you're just sitting there rooting for Jesse Eisenberg.
Yeah, exactly.
That's a problem.
Oh my God, he was so bad.
So I haven't seen the movie.
Jesus Christ, he's annoying.
Because
they tried to make him
Superman.
They tried to make him like the Joker.
Yeah,
like
zany.
They just made him
like
crazy
random.
And like
and
Lex Luthor.
Lex
Luthor.
He's cold and calculated.
Exactly. And he had reasons for what he did. Like,
exactly.
And Joker had a reason, but.
He just wants fucking anarchy.
But Lex
Luthor
didn't even have a reason. He was just like, fuck these guys. I'm just going to kill
people. I'm fucking
everything
up for no reason. Like, just like, oh,
come on. And they had, like, over an hour of convoluted storyline and preaching.
Yeah.
And none of it explained why anything was happening.
Not at all.
It's like, what the
fuck? It's just, like, the whole movie, at least my first time through, I felt it was super choppy and super, like, it was just jumpy, and there was, like, the part where I'm gonna go into a certain part, basically, and obviously it's not gonna ruin much for you, because the part doesn't make any fucking sense in the first place. So Batman is, like, having a dream at his, like, basically in the Batcave,
mm-hmm.
and he wakes up, and this fucking thing flashes through a portal. It's the Flash! So this thing comes through a portal, and it's, like, yelling at him. It's like, Lois is the key! It's just screaming in his face. It's the craziest thing. There's no context for it. There's no other... There's, like, nothing that, like, helps you understand
basically,
why
it's
happened.
Like, there's obviously going to be sequels, and this will mean something later in another movie.
It's like, that's... Like, that... You still have to have something that's pre-existing to make me understand why that's going to be relevant. Like... You know, a lot of movies do that, where it's like, there's this little thing that you forgot about, but we're going to bring it back three movies later, but it's always something that isn't, like, overstated like that.
Yeah, super random.
Like, it was just, like, it seems so out of place, and then I didn't like that at all. But The Flash is my favorite DC superhero, so I was like, yeah, I want to see more of him. You don't, so that's always...
Well, you do in that little video clip.
Yeah, like that little clip, of course, but I don't know. I was at odds with
So the movie wasn't as awful as everyone said it was. Like, it got really bad crap, but...
I don't think it's as bad as people, like, thought it
It's
was.
Just not good, and...
It's not enjoyable.
It's not fun at all,
No.
And most of the action you see in the trailers already.
Yeah.
So that already kind of gets spoiled for you, and, you know...
And that was one of those movies... Like, I've noticed a huge influx, like, in the past few years of, like... Movies that spoil everything in the trailer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, and I think that's just so annoying. Like, I miss, like, the mystique that movies used to have.
If you're throwing out a 3-minute trailer, you're doing your job wrong.
Like you're giving away the entire movie.
You know a trailer I like and is really good. The Force Awakens.
It's so good.
It gets the feel perfectly.
Yeah.
Introduces the characters without like saying.
And there's almost zero dialogue.
Yeah. It's just so. And I've watched it still, and I'm like, man, I'm getting emotional.
especially after super seeing it, you're like, wow, this is fucking great. That was actually, okay, so I'm going to have that dumbass opinion where when Disney bought Star Wars, I was like, I'm scared.
Yeah.
Like, I'm nervous. Because my uncle introduced me to Star Wars when I was a young man, and that was like, I have really fond memories of watching Star Wars with my uncle and my grandfather, who has passed away since then. And so, like, that's, like, some of my favorite memories of that, him in general. So seeing Star Wars brought back to life is, like, it's concerning to me, almost, at first. Mm-hmm. When I saw it, or that trailer, actually, the first time I saw that trailer, like, the real one,
yeah.
I was like, I am no longer worried about a goddamn thing.
Yeah.
Like, this is gonna feel so nostalgic. I'm gonna have the happiest memories from this. I don't know why I questioned it in the first place, because Disney crushes everything that they touch.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm very, very happy with that trailer and with the movie in general. Like, it was just great.
Yeah. I can relate to that. Like so many before us, you know, my dad was into Star Wars, and he introduced me to Star Wars, and that was like a thing. And my dad also has since passed.
Oh, they
died. Yeah, absolutely.
So, like, it was very cathartic.
Yeah.
Even,
like,
it's
more emotional than you think it's gonna be.
Yeah,
more emotional than it should be.
Yeah. It's like they knew.
For a movie.
They really took into consideration just how important of a presence it is in people's lives.
Yeah.
And you can kind of feel that, and it's like, hey, we know that this is gonna fuck you up.
Yeah, like you're gonna feel
in like the best possible
in the next
way.
Few hours.
Yeah,
I'm gonna pull up the map.
And yeah, so they just did a really good job.
We should go back. Yeah,
haters gonna hate all that shit.
Oh,
you know,
exactly.
Whatever.
I don't even want none of the above. I'm gonna piss on you. Drip, drip, drip.
Piss on you.
So I actually, so I had one of the biggest smacks in the dick before Star Wars, actually, before The Force Awakens. I tried really hard after that initial trailer to not read anything.
Yeah.
And to, like, I wanted to go in completely blind.
Yep.
And, like, I just want to experience that. Because, again, like I said, like, just, you know, like, my grandfather and, like, reasons behind that and everything. It was just, like, I think I just want this to be, like, an experience, basically. And, like, really, like, hold that memory, like, real close while I get to see this movie. And, like, everything. Like, it was just gonna be perfect for me. And so, I hopped on Facebook one day.
Oh, no.
Right before the movie released. Like, day before it's about to hop in. And I had been avoiding it, but I was like, you know, like, I'm at work, like, whatever, I'm bored. First thing on my feed. Complete spoiler. It was the worst thing I've ever experienced. I was so mad. Like, I think unreasonably mad at that point, actually. Like, usually I don't get mad at just about anything.
Like, you punch through your monitor and have to get a new one.
Oh, man, I was just so mad, just in general. I think I actually, like, I commented on that one. And normally, like, I don't get into, like, the Facebook.
Those whiny
yeah,
people are
exactly.
like, why are you spoiling me?
Yeah. Like, normally I don't do anything like that, but I was like, dude, this is a total dick move. Like, you're an asshole, actually. Like I'm really surprised that I'm not driving to your house right now. Like, this is... That's fucked up. Because, like, I don't think people note how that impacted our culture.
Yeah.
As far as that goes. Like, how nerd culture has become so prominent and everything. Like, I think we owe a shitload of that to Star Wars. And just in general, and like how the relationships, like father to son, grandfather to son, uncle, like, you know, anything like that, like how those relationships still like kind of pass through into Star Wars 7.
Yeah.
And so, like, to me, that was like, dude, you just took away a huge moment for me. Like, you know, like that's pretty fucked up, like, as a human being. You know, I was like, I get it. I shouldn't have been on social media, but god damn it, that's a dick move.
Dude, Billy and I and Elijah, my brother, we went to it on opening night.
Yeah.
And it was just such an awesome experience because it was full.
And I think I know what spoiler you're talking about.
Oh, yeah.
And we actually, the weird thing is, I remember discussing it on our way to the theater.
Uh-huh.
We were like, so do you think this is going to happen? I feel like this is going to happen.
Billy, you can talk about it.
Yeah,
like,
it's been long.
All the people who would have seen it by now
would
have seen it.
So, you know, we had the discussion. I was like, so do you guys think Han is going to die? Do you think they're going to kill off Han? And it was a resounding yes. In the car, like, we're pretty sure this is going to happen.
Yeah, like, somebody's got to go.
And I'm going to fucking cry.
Yeah.
Like, I told him, I was like, I might cry if that happens.
But here's, like, watching it, like, on the opening night and with a crowd of people and everyone huge diehard Star Wars fans, it was so awesome.
Oh, yeah,
like,
absolutely.
Seeing
just an experience.
When you see the Millennium Falcon, everyone just started cheering and laughing. I'm like, this is so fucking awesome.
Yeah. Oh, so, kind of funny anecdote, but kind of also kind of sad. About that.
Oh,
Rhonda.
Shit. Rhonda. I'm stuck. I'm a big girl.
So, everybody, like, when Han and Chewie made their appearance, you know, their first introduction appearance in the movie, there were cheers and claps and stuff. And then when the Millennium Falcon, you know, made its first appearance on screen, you know, everybody was happy about that and stuff. And then we see Princess Leia. For the first time, we see Carrie Fisher. No,
nobody made a sound.
No reaction. But then, immediately after, C-3PO does this little thing, and everybody's like, yay! And I was just like, Carrie Fisher got zero fucking reaction.
Oh,
but fucking
so
3PO got a resounding yay.
I think.
Do you remember how quiet it was, though, on the bridge scene when... because everyone knew. Everyone was like, this is going to happen.
This is not going to
happen. Everyone was just like,
just
fucking
silence.
Just holding breath.
Oh,
that whole fucking theater was holding its breath,
oh,
and
God.
It's insane.
I think I could, I'll totally, like, to give that kind of, like, my anecdote at least, I compare that to Pokemon Go lately. Like, the way that I have experienced Pokemon Go in, like, the community and everything lately.
Yeah.
Like, you guys seeing that opening night for, like, everything and, like, seeing
everybody
who's so into it and, like, ready. Dude,
just
Pokemon
that
Go.
Collective
Pokemon Go.
Love.
Yeah.
And,
everyone's
like, just being
been
a community.
So stoked.
Like, really being a community.
Yeah, there's a fucking Twirtle over here. Like, it's been so rad.
Yeah.
Like, we went on the weekend after it like came out and everything like that. It only been out for like 3 days or so, and that was still like, that was just awesome to like go on a main street in Cedar Falls and there's fucking 70 other people playing Pokemon Go, just like walking down the street, grabbing Pokestops, setting up lures. It was fucking great. Oh my God, super happy with that. It's
absolutely
been money.
So we're fighting the Lord of Gluttony right now.
Yeah, he's a bitch.
Awesome.
He's interesting enough, there's no sign of food down here.
Yeah, yeah, right? I was confused.
Because it's all inside of him.
Because he ate it all.
Yeah.
I see it now.
Woo!
So this might be an extra long episode. We should cut it after this.
Yeah, it's probably good.
Fair
it's
enough.
Been a minute, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, we're at the
And we need to get rid of some inventory because everybody's. Ravening beasts! Yeah! We're gluttons for loot! Anyway.
Right. Ted's taking us back to town.
Alright, we'll see you guys in the next episode.
Peace out, homies.
Bye. I got it.